we did get confirmation late yesterday afternoon from the head of the Bali Prosecutor's Office here that both Andrew Chan and Mayuren Sukumaran will be transferred from Kerobokan Prison here in Bali to Central Java this week. Now, we understand that it's unlikely to happen today, but definitely in the coming days. And they will be escorted out of the prison by paramilitary officers and then flown on a chartered plane to Central Java, where the executions are set to take place. So it certainly seems that preparations are well underway for the next round of executions.
We are not going to compromise for drug dealers. No compromise.
We do understand that once they are transferred, an execution date will then be set for all the prisoners on death row. We did see, after a few years, the first round of executions last month, and quite some backlash there, with both the Netherlands and Brazil recalling their ambassadors after their citizens were executed. So whether or not there'll be some backlash or some repercussions in terms of what the federal government does is still yet to be seen, but certainly Tony Abbott has hinted at things like that if the killings do go ahead.
The decision to execute these two Australians is coming out of Jakarta, out of the government in Jakarta. I think from what I can ascertain, a lot of Balinese think it's as misguided as we do. We've got a very long and rich and close history with the Balinese. You'll recall that there were two terrorist attacks there, and which drew us very close to the Balinese. And it just seems a pity that we're now turning our backs on them. But at the end of the day, it's a very special place, and I just think it'd be a terrible shame to sever the ties with Bali. People are saying they won't go to Indonesia again. The reality is that very, very few Australians go to what is effectively the mainland of Indonesia, Java, and the thousands of other islands that make up the country. Virtually all of our tourism is to Bali because we don't really have any interest, sadly, in travelling into the rest of Indonesia. So if we do boycott Indonesia, the boycott will focus on Bali. But I think what will happen is that people will just indirectly boycott Bali by just feeling a bit squeamish about going there because it will just rob the destination of some of its magic, I guess. So even if people decide that they're not going to actively support the boycott, they may just tend to look to other destinations. So Indonesia and Bali in particular will probably suffer no matter what happens.